Maulana Jalaluddin al-Balkhi, or more famously known in the West as Rumi. Born in the year 1207 AD, which is in the famous city of Balkh, which is in modern-day Afghanistan. He migrated to Anatolia due to fear of the Mongol invasion when he was quite young, and that is where he settled with his family, and that is where he flourished as one of the greatest scholars this ummah has ever seen. He was a polymath. He was not only a master of poetry and language, he was also a master of Islamic law, hadith, and tafsir. And he epitomized that within his poetry while giving commentary on verses of the Quran, commentaries of hadith through his poetry. The goal of this series will be to highlight corroborations he made between his poetry and those verses of the Quran and those prophetic traditions of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We begin a poem as an introduction where Mawlana mentions in his Diwan al-Shams, he says, Man bandai Quranam agar jaan daram, man khaake dare Muhammadi mukhtaram, gar naql kunad juz in kas az guftaram, bezaram azu wazin sukhan bezaram. This is the premise, and this is what his poetry is predicated on. He says, I am the slave of the Quran for as long as I live. He continues and he says, I am the dust beneath the door of Muhammad, the chosen one. He continues, he says, whoever quotes me, whoever quotes something from me that is not from these two sources mentioned above, meaning the Quran and the prophetic tradition, what does he say? Bezaram azu wazin sukhan bezaram. I have nothing to do with that individual and I have nothing to do with that statement. Meaning everything he has written within his Methnawi, his Diwan al-Shams, the poetry he has uttered so beautifully with his tongue, this is all things from within our deen. It's all things based and premised on our beloved Islam. He continues in another part of the Diwan al-Shams, he says, قافل سالار ما فخر جهان مصطفاست. He says, the leader of our grand caravan of this life, فخر جهان مصطفاست. It is the pride of the entire universe, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Again, giving further evidence indicating that his poetry and his teachings are from the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So as mentioned, today is just an introductory to this series. Insha'Allah ta'ala, by the grace of Allah and by the ability provided by Allah, granted by Allah, we will cover a poem every single week with a short commentary, demonstrating that these poems are not only from himself, but they are predicated and commentaries of the Quran and the Sunnah. And we'll also speak about some of the wisdoms within that poetry, some of the concepts of tazkiyah. In Mawlana, he was a mutazakki, he was a mutasawwif, and he was a man who really emphasized the ruhani, the spiritual aspects of our beloved faith known as tazkiyah. And we will speak about those aspects within his poetry.